speech. I have one question for all of you. Do you know how UUM students study nowadays? Yeah, yes. This is how UUM students study. This is the UUM student saying, "I am going to study starter pack." They burn their midnight oil in Magdi, having the Maggie, and then they still swiping their social media. So, that's why today I am here. I want to share you an idea on how to be concentrated in 5 minutes. So, when I was in secondary school, I wasn't a good student. I failed all of my subjects, and I even get a last place in my class. Then I start asking myself. I start to research for a theory to start or a technique to study. Then I found this, the Pomodoro technique, which also named as the Tomato Theory. It's by Francesco Cirillo in the late 1980s. The technique is like this. It's using a timer, like tomato, to break down the work into intervals. Then, traditionally, it's 25 minutes in length, which is separated by the short breaks. So I will explain how it goes. First, you decide the task to be done. And then, set the timer to 25 minutes. Don't go pedaling. I'm not saying I'm using this negatively. Okay. And then you work really hard on the task and you focus until you finish the task. Only you can get 5 minute break. Then you repeat this process for 4 times. Then you can take a 15 to 30 minute big breaks. I actually was trying this technique, but I feel, why? You know, it's really hard for me to even focus to study in 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and even if I'm saying to study for the whole day. So, I start research for the human attention span. And this is what I found from the Telegraph Science by Leon Wetzel. According to the research, the human average attention span in year 2000 is 12 seconds. And until today, because of the technology, because of the social media, because of this all kind of interruption, and our human attention base has decreased until only 8.25 seconds. The most funny thing is this, our human attention span is even lower than the goldfish. You know, the goldfish has only 9 second memory and our human attention span is only 8.25 seconds. So, I start finding my own technique and develop my own theory. And I make a conclusion. The Pomodoro technique is not applicable. Before I start to tell you my technique, I would like to have a learning by doing interactive session and also give some of you to be on the stage. Okay, first I want to cue my charming protocol to be on the stage first. Then, I need 2 volunteers from among all of you. Okay, you. Thanks, bro. And who else has? Okay, you. Thank you, thank you. Please welcome, please welcome. Hi, what's your name? Esha.
Hi,
Esha.
Nice to meet you.
And what's your name?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Nice to meet you. Okay, my charming protocol will reveal 2 of you. 2 potato. Each of you a potato and a straw. Yes. Okay, taking the straw. Okay, you have a potato and you have a straw. Okay, and now I want you to do is strike to me. Yes, you think I got me wrong. Strike through the potato. Strike, yeah. You think I'm wrong, yeah. Strike. No, no, using the straw to strike through the potato. Try. Yeah, like this. Strike through it. Can you do it? It's very right. Okay, so I am doing this together with you.
paid. The thing is this. Let us try together. Can you give this a support?
Just now, I want to use the bubble shape straw you all have, but I found it's too easy, so I want to challenge myself. Oh, it's okay. And then, the technique is this. First, they can't strike through, because the technique is you have to thumb at the straw hole, then only you can strike through the potato. Because when you thumb at the straw, the air will compress inside the straw and strike through the potato. But I'm not going to teach you physics today, don't worry. What I want to tell you is, imagine that a straw cannot strike through a potato. But the story is, don't judge a book by its cover. You can do whatever you want when you are focused. And then, since Francesco Cirillo has his own tomato theory, then I here come my own potato theory. First, of course, you decide the task to be done, like you want to study. Then, you study for 5 minutes. Is it hilarious? Yes, you didn't get me wrong. Study for only 5 minutes. Because of our human attention span, I'm telling you to just study for 5 minutes so you can really focus in that 5 minutes. Then, get a rest for 5 minutes. But, it's not end yet. After you get used to that 5 minutes, add another 5 minutes into your study. And then you will be studying for 10 minutes for this period. Then rest again for 5 minutes. And the process go again, again, and again. Time by time you increase the time, you study 5 minutes, then rest for 5 minutes, study 10 minutes, you rest again 5 minutes, and in between. And the best of this system is this. There is a break in between. It becomes the motivation for you to finish your task in order to get the rest. And the best thing is this, until you keep until 40 minutes in consecutive, then you can get a 40 minutes big break. The theory is actually similar with this, the frog's boiling theory. Imagine this, here is a pot with 100 degrees Celsius boiling water. Then I throw a frog inside the water. What happened? Ladies and gentlemen, what happened? Yes, the frog will jump out. And then, imagine another situation. I put a ball, a sand ball, but with the 37 degrees Celsius room temperature water. Then, again, I throw the frog. The frog will enjoy the water, and it will swim joyfully. But now, start heating up the water. Time by time, the temperature increase, and it's too late for the, when the pot is hitting the boiling point, it's too late for the frog to jump out from the boiling pot already. So, what I want to tell you is this. I want all of you to be the frog today. Serious. If I'm telling you to study for 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 15 minutes, or even one day, don't cheat yourself again. If I'm telling you to study for 30 minutes, you will be like a frog throwing into the boiling point. What you will do? You will escape from it. So that's the theory. I want you to study, start from 5 minutes, and then you increase the time phase by phase. Ladies and gentlemen, our brain is like our body's muscles. Imagine this. Every athlete, even Kobe Bryant, Yao Ming, Usain Bolt, what they do before they start their sport activity? They stretching. They stretch again and again. Then only they increase the intensity of their training and time phase by phase. Then same goes to our brain. Our brain is like our body's master. Our brain also need to work out. We have to increase the intensity of the study or training time and time, face by face, like we are doing sport. Do not just use your brain, but using it wisely. And stop saying that you want to study for today, but say that I am going to finish the study by this amount of time. Ladies and gentlemen, before I end my speech, I want to bring you a quote. Ambitious people, they don't work against time. They work with time. Thank you.